Average 30-year mortgage rates bust the threes. Welcome back. I'm Sean Casilli with Coldwell Banker Realty, and you are at the YouTube channel Bay Real Experts, the channel that's aimed at educating you on the real estate market so your next move can be smart. All right, you guys, let's jump straight into this topic. Ever since mortgage rates have been tracked, this is like the fifth or sixth time I've said this, I know, but this is really awesome news. The average 30-year mortgage rate just dropped to 2.98%. I haven't seen it below the threes on the average ever. And in fact, you know, if you have watched the previous videos that's been covering these crashes on interest rates, which is a good thing for consumers, they were all the way down into the threes, but never have they broke the threes since it's been tracked since 1971. That's 50 years of never seeing the threes. Now, I will say that although 2.98 was the average for this week, we know there are some rates that are out there where no points were being paid. And on an investment property, one of our clients got a 2.75 on a 30-year fixed. No points. So there's some deals to be had if you have amazing credit and talk and have a great relationship with your lender. So talk to them for the best rate. You might be able to do better than 2.98%. Stay tuned to the end of the episode. I want to give you a tip on 1031 exchanges, but for now, I want to talk about what is going on with the pandemic and the protests and coronavirus and everything that's going on in the news. How has it affected real estate? So according to Realtor.com, median home sale prices are up 6.2% year over year. And Fannie Mae did a housing survey where of the respondents, 61% of them said it was a great time to buy, and 41% of them said now is a great time to sell. Why it's not more than 41%, I'm not sure, but I will tell you, at least in our hyper-local market here in Bay County, Panama City Beach, Florida, it is definitely a seller's market. When properties are first hitting the market, we're seeing multiple offers, often over asking price, and we are seeing, unfortunately, we're seeing a lot of buyers that are missing out on opportunities. And I promise you, there are buyers that are in the market waiting for you to list your home. So if you're interested in doing that, please give me a call. I would love to help you with that. I'll leave my contact information below. And I did promise you guys a tip on 1031 exchanges, but a little disclaimer first, make sure you talk to your CPA, your attorney, about your specific 1031 exchange and make sure you get the best advice from them about your specific 1031 exchange. So just a really high level overview of a 1031 exchange. We're gonna have property A in one hand, you already own it, and it's a commercial property that you are going to sell. So the day of closing, don't touch your money. It goes to a qualified intermediary. And then you have 45 days to identify a like-kind property to reinvest all of those funds into. So now you have property B. You should identify one to three properties within 45 days of closing property A. You have 180 days to close on property B. So what if property 1, 2, and 3 that you've chose as your like-kind exchange, there's a fall through for some reason? Well, the tip that I want to share with you guys is something called Opportunity Zone Funds and Delaware Statutory Trusts. This can be a placeholder for your option number 3. Let's say you've identified property number 1. Something falls through. Well, you have a backup. You have property number 2 identified. What if something happens there and there's a fall through? Well, if you have as your third option an Opportunity Zone Fund or a Delaware Statutory Trust set up as your fallback, you can still accomplish your 1031 exchange. And here's the reason that I'm bringing this up. There was, you know, because of COVID, there was an extension given for people that were supposed to reach their decision time of making their 1031 exchange by April 6th through 13th, I want to say. Because of COVID, they were allowed until July 15th to complete that exchange. And there was a shortage of not only inventory of properties to make a 1031 exchange with, but also on opportunity zone funds and DSTs. Those Delaware statutory trusts were, the availability, the inventory of those were down by like 20%. So we're looking at the 19th today. So some of those may be ready to roll over again, and there may be more inventory. And I want to just make a request here. If you are an expert, qualified intermediary that deals with opportunity zone funds or 1031 exchanges, please send me a message. We have clients that are looking to get to know you. So if you need property you need to buy or sell in Panama City Beach or anywhere in Bay County, we would love to help you with that. And speaking of investment property, check out the video we did on this condo that we have listed for sale and see if it's a good fit for you and your 1031 exchange, or if you're just jumping into the real estate market as an investor. This is how we market property. We'd love to help you whether you're on the buying or selling side of things. And in the meantime, stay safe, stay healthy, and stay positive, you guys. It's worth it. Be happy. Bye for now.